It's happened again! That is, today we return to the VTuber agency Nijisanji. This morning, sending out this notice regarding one of their talents, Gundou Mirei, a VTuber who has been with the company for over 4 years now, known by many to be an outspoken member, and for quite a long time, has amassed a number of haters and antis. That's stemming from numerous incidents, such as not believing where she says she was vacationing from, all the way to not thinking that she is role-playing her role correctly. And now regarding this notice of Gundou Mirei, it states, "We deeply apologize to the many people who were offended by the postings of Gundou Mirei. In order to prevent similar incidents from occurring in the future, we will provide thorough guidance to all of our livers. We appreciate your continued support." The actual notice reads, "On March 22nd, Gundou Mirei, a member of the company's live performers, posted an inappropriate baseball-related post on the social network service Twitter." Let's go ahead and repeat that. A member of the company's live performers posted an inappropriate baseball-related post on the social network service Twitter. "We deeply apologize for the discomfort this tweet caused to many people, including baseball fans, and we hope you will accept our sincere apology." In addition to this incident, she has said and done inappropriate things several times since she started her activities as a member of our company. Despite our repeated warnings, she still posted the tweet in question. "The company believes this is a serious problem and that this tweet by the said liver shows a lack of awareness by a streamer. In light of the above circumstances, the company has decided to suspend the said liver from activities for the time being, starting today, March 23rd. We have already made arrangements with the relevant parties regarding the content of the projects featuring said liver. We would like to reiterate our sincere condolences to the many people who have been affected by this incident. In order to prevent similar problems from occurring in the future, we will conduct compliance training again for the relevant livers and continue to thoroughly educate and instruct other livers as well." Okay, so you heard right. This VTuber made a post about baseball, and that then led to her suspension. So why was this such a big deal? Well, it so happens at the time that the World Baseball Classic was finishing up, this being a worldwide tournament in which Japan defeated the USA. During this time, the VTuber was effectively live tweeting, asking many questions about baseball, and being educated about the game by her fans. This tweet thread altogether had 125 posts, but it was this tweet, 25 posts in, that blew up, here with 13 million views and nearly 6,000 quote retweets. The tweet itself effectively reading, "Wouldn't the pitcher get suspended if they threw the baseball at the head or the body of good players?" Now, that's one translation of the tweet. There are other ways to interpret this tweet, as Gundou does not directly mention a batter, but instead is talking about a tougher or stronger player, leading some to wonder also if she's asking if the pitcher is the one that will be suspended or the batter. Further underlining, this might be a legitimate question and not just a facetious joke. This then led to numerous interpretations about this question, many positing that this VTuber was advocating for the pitcher to throw the baseball at someone's head, likely the one at bat, many then pointing out how dangerous that can be, Twitter sending out that tweet to so many people that even days later, in a good morning tweet like this one from this morning, this VTuber is still being effectively asked or harassed about that particular tweet. The story even being picked up by Sports Nippon, one of the three biggest sports periodicals around, and giving a good account of what happened here, remarking, "Gundou Mirei, a popular VTuber with over 460,000 subscribers, apologized for an inappropriate comment she made during the 5th World Baseball Classic held on the same day. Gundou, who had no knowledge of baseball, was giving a play-by-play report, asking, 'What is a strike? Does a home run score a run?' She surprised users by tweeting such questions, including that question we saw before, 'Can't the person who throws the ball be suspended if they throw it at the other person's head or body?' That tweet receiving replies like, 'This is really a bad thing to say, and you can't say that even in jest.' After the game, Gundou posted, 'I watched a full baseball game for the first time, and it was fun. I heard we became the best in the world. I'm so happy. I'm glad I stayed up all night.' Adding, 'There was some inappropriate comments due to my ignorance, but I just want to reiterate that I have no malicious intent. I'm sorry.' That attention and then leading to this suspension. Some users also stating that this was not done specifically just to protect the talent, citing if that was the case, then why in the official statement point out that the talent herself had not listened to the company in regards to posting tweets like these? But again, the question is, why was this so important to Nijisanji? Well, it turns out Nijisanji has quite a lot of ties to baseball, being sponsored by the National Central League, and their very biggest event of the year is the Nijisanji Koishin. This multi-stream event enlisting tons of Nijisanji talents, wherein they're assigned roles in the Konami game Power Pros. These streams are so popular in Japan that some of them top out at 200,000 viewers. That said, this has created a bit of a culture clash, especially those in the West, saying, did you really just suspend Mirei because she got ratioed by Japanese baseball nerds? What the hell is going on at any color? No fun allowed, they said. So much for Nijisanji being the chill and relaxed corporation. Friends don't let friends become attached to Nijisanji talent. You can't say any jokes with this company. Getting suspended for making baseball jokes is insane. Based, no one makes fun of baseball. Many of the Japanese comments were far more understanding or wanted even harsher penalties against this VTuber. And while it is not clear that if these commenters were VTuber viewers, we did have other comments such as this one that were a bit more understanding, stating, I protest this decision of the official Nijisanji. If someone who knows nothing about baseball makes an inappropriate statement regarding dead balls, what exactly is the problem? I am at a loss to understand. A personality cannot be omniscient, so this makes it impossible for them to speak on everything that they don't know much about. And further, we have this comment. This VTuber's comments are certainly problematic. It's not something that should be taken lightly, but I think there are a lot of creepy people who just find a chance to slap the VTubers and take pleasure in it. There are too many people on Twitter who have no sense of justice and just want to feel good about slapping people. So once again, with Nijisanji, another day, another indefinite suspension. As also with Nijisanji, we turn to Finana Ryugu with Nijisanji English, sharing these two new logos, and also a very personal journey of hers recently, stating, I haven't been able to properly take care of myself lately, and I've been so overworked that I wore the same clothes the entire month. I was ashamed, but I am not afraid to be honest about it either. But I'm proud to say that I finally broke that habit today. I know it sounds gross and nasty, haha, stinky, but it's the truth, and I hope that no one else has to go through that. So I'm here to remind you all to take care of yourselves, eat, sleep, and most importantly, have fun. This while Finana was having fun with Raid Shadow Legends. What? Yeah, we have more Raid Shadow Legends streams. That is, we also turn to Selene Tatsuki of NijiEN. Also here with a Raid Shadow Legends stream, saying, wait, is this real? Did I finally get a Raid Shadow Legends sponsor? I'm a real YouTuber now, not clickbait. This while Selene shared Diamond City Lights lo-fi music video. It's finally here. We are almost to the end of the lo-fi project. Fully animated music video will release on March 24th. And speaking of Selene, we have this Commander artwork from Shannon at Honey Puffs. But it's also this artwork that is turning a lot of heads. Yes, we have an official Nijisanji English collaboration with the IPStar Café. These cafes in Shanghai, Nanjing, and Guangzhou. This stunning artwork can be seen in these Chinese cafes, soon promising some artwork of male livers who will be a part of this collab. The artwork itself from Bibelkyo, saying, I'm very happy to be the designer of the main visuals of three girls for this event. Hope you enjoy it. Further, we have this announcement from the Cyber Sakura 2023 event, revealing that attendees can play Apex Legends with Selene Tatsuki, sharing there are two methods. Players will be chosen via a random draw before the event, and then secondly, more players will be chosen via an Apex tournament. And speaking of Apex and Selene, she's taking part in her first full team practice with an official coach, that being for the upcoming Shibuya Hao Vsaikyo tournament, seen here with her other teammates on Team Snake Bite, Axel Sirius and Regis Altair of Hollow Tempest. That's right, and we have that Team Snake Bite drip here from Cole. Shibuya Hao here on stream introducing the team, but perhaps not knowing the origin of the team name. That while we now have the official announcement for their team coach, it's Nocturnal. Selene saying, we are honored to have him guide us throughout the tournament. Next up with Nijisanji English, we have Ike Eveland. This past weekend, taking part in Anime Impulse along with the other hoes, as Vox Akuma would call them. Ike taking to Twitter to say, bro, the Twitter bug with random tweets being deleted by themselves for no reason is starting to get really annoying. Ververmillion replying, seriously, I started to think I was making these tweets up. Ike further asking, how does this even happen? Well, we addressed that very issue in our last episode, that as it appears, years, various tweets are being region-locked, as also with Nijisanji English, we move to Yo Kaneko, experiencing his own problems with Twitter, saying, for some reason, I can't see any posts that were posted from January to March in my art and thumbnail tag. But the tagged individual posts, I can still see if they have links, so they aren't deleted? Kyo also sharing, I raided into this sick shiz. That being a stream for Scarle Yonaguni, also with Nijisanji English. And hey, would you look at that? That background looks very familiar. Very, very familiar. So familiar, in fact, that we recognized it from this file photo of Hex Haywire. His fans calling this the Red Room, with some being mistaken, thinking it was made for him by other fans. Not quite. This is actually a background you yourself can purchase right now for less than $20, labeled as a VTuber BDSM background, complete with normal lighting, red lighting, areas for chat, and so much more. Applying to that tweet from Kyo, she would say, you all saw nothing. Kyo doesn't know what he saw. That is, Scarlett was getting a lot of attention recently for thumbnails like this one, using artwork from Mythic Arts, yesterday showing even more of that artwork on a YouTube thumbnail, revealing some differently colored skin. Scarlett would later change the thumbnail for the stream after it had concluded, but a number of her videos are garnering a lot of attention and yet somehow still remaining monetized. However, what was not censored was this photo, as this liver would share, moldy strawberries from when I got back home. Nijisanji's Etna Crimson replying, if we remove the mold, can we still eat those strawberries? That particular tweet racking up 1 million views. As very quickly, we turn to Hall Live English's Takanashi Kiara, also sharing, I've been feeling super dizzy and sick since I woke up. Is it because I ate half rotten strawberries? And we also had Hall Live Indonesia's Muna Hoshinova tweeting out, I'm mad over myself. I bought the strawberry shortcake yesterday and put it in the refrigerator, but I didn't eat it because I arrived at the hotel and I was already tired. Today I went to eat it and realized the strawberries were already rotten. Thankfully, we had a happy ending from Scarla presenting these non-rotten strawberry ice cream rolls. And also regarding Scarla, we turn to WeebCon, set for April 7th to 9th, wherein her and the others in Iluna will be making an appearance, participating in a Q&A and also meet and greet on Saturday and Sunday. More info on this coming tomorrow. And yes, once again, this is the same event that myself and so many other VTubers will be attending. Thanks so much to Uwu Market for hosting us. As next with NijiEN, we have Kotoka Torahime, seen here with the rest of Ex-Soleil wiggling around, courtesy of Aurelia Graphics. Kotoka also sharing, if something's rotting in your house, you can always just put it in the freezer to help you forget about the smell and the existence of it. Further sharing that she had sold her fridge because she doesn't cook, but also after buying ingredients asking, how long does raw meat last in room temperature? Kotoka would share this amazing Gyaru Cooking 3. Now who says she doesn't cook? And also tweeting out, so me and Mikoto-senpai are gonna have a bath date tomorrow, but how to sanitize your bathtub? That being Nijisanji liver Rindo Mikoto, wondering why Kotoka was asking such a question, and then joining in on this Senpai Cleans My Room stream. A stream that, not surprisingly, led to some drinking. Also with XLA, we have Nijisanji English's Meloco Kyoran, seen here with Kotoka and this orange and grape artwork from Goose. And oh my, look at those oranges and grapes. Meloco again showing off her leather straps and stating, welcome to my club, Senpais. One of those Senpais being Kazaki Morinaka. As here, the two took part in an off-collab duet karaoke session and further bridging the gap between NijiEN and NijiJP. All right, now it's time for Ren Zotto, the deadly alien prince, teasing us with 2 days left, that being for the release of Wanderer on May 25th, this being the same day as his birthday, as then on the next day we have Fulgur Ovid celebrating his birthday the day after Ren. And yes, he also has some birthday goods, complete with this new artwork, that by way of Lan Mama, stating happy birthday, Foo. And now the moment you've all been waiting for, the reveal of the true form of Fulgur Ovid, giving us this welcome home master, nya. NijiEN's Alira Pandora replying, I can't even think of a reply. I'm just so in shock. These assets coming from Pico, having a little bit of fun here. Quasi trying to trick Fu-chan, saying, I drew you a Chinese Kung Fu asset. It's a pre-fight pose. It's more powerful than the middle finger in China. Next time you want to use your middle finger or bonk stick, try this for more damage. It's definitely not a cat pose. I mean, it's just a culture cultural deference. If you don't trust me, you can just ask any Chinese confidant. They will give you the same answer. And those ears, it's a wolf. Yes, wolf ears. That means you're evil and bold. And if you don't like the cat wolf ears, there are some goat horns for you too. Yes, here we have the cat wolf eared assets, and admittedly some very good looking goat assets. After trying them on, Fulgur saying it was for a Batsu, a punishment game, that then leading to this mess of a response. Coming by way of good friend Nijisanji English's Uki Violeta, formally announcing, so excited to announce that I will no longer be giving a fuck. Can't wait to see where this takes me and hope you'll come along for the ride. Fulgur replying, the energy we need in 2023. That while Uki would also thank his fans for 1 million views on his Waltz of Malice performance. Also letting us know, surprise, Lunum will be available on streaming platforms on April 8th. The song earlier being released. And dare we say, it almost looks like there was some space there to the left for someone else. But maybe that's just our imagination. As entirely unrelated now, we turn to the unnamed account. That's right, it's Usan, letting us know they have opened and are posting to their Instagram, further receiving these wigglies from Aurelia Graphics, and further releasing new wallpapers, available only for 7 days, and with Usan asking, please do not repost or reprint them on any other social media. Then all while, this talent has been having a lot of fun with YouTube, and we mean lots of fun. Yes, look how the two get along. Further, the talent would share this message. I said you can make merch out of me if you're making artwork of your own, but when it's coming from fan art or other designers, that's a different story. Artworks that I post on social media are commissioned, but fan art, that's something that was done for free. Clarifying, if you wish to make something out of fan art, please try to understand each artwork's background. Is it my official art? Was it just fan art? Let's try to keep that in mind. In addition, I noticed many fan arts in our hashtags were traced from other creators. And I'm not talking about the memes. Even though I am doing my best to avoid them and ignore them, there are many of them. I'm really sorry, but I don't appreciate those fan arts. Tracing is part of the learning process, but don't claim that those are your own work. I do not want anyone to get depressed because of it. Please know that I'm not posting here to offend anyone because we're all learning together. Let's improve together every day. And now also we are announcing the release of this music video from Usan, that being a cover song from the film One Piece Red, and may we say equals the power of the original song. And we're not done yet. No, there's more with Nijisanji Japan. After all, it's the 4th anniversary of the Sanbaka trio, receiving brand new artwork, one after another, from their character illustrators. Also now releasing a brand new music video for one of their previous songs. This 4th anniversary also coming with the announcement of brand new merchandise. These orders will be available until April 6th, as one of the trio's members, Inui Toko, earlier today shared this brand new look. Yes, she is a full maid with her mascots now too, and they have some cake for you. Next, we have former Nijisanji Indonesia talent, Hakarajaman, promoting some official goods. Yes, it's true. Nijisanji on their booth site is promoting some ex-Nijisanji Indonesia goods. Haka confirming that he had worked on this merchandise himself, including a tote bag, t-shirt, key holder, and more. As also formerly of Nijisanji Indonesia, we have Mika letting us know that she has gone live on Twitch.tv with this image. Thanks for that. Further sharing, she has a problem. Having listened to some point of view videos on YouTube, such as they want you to dance for them only, and they just wanted to play with you the whole time. Scarla also replying, no, cause actual same. This as she had listened to some You're Sandwiched Between Dobby Hawks at a Nightclub video. What the? Meanwhile, Mika had taken part in a game of Uno with some Hall Live Indonesia talent. One of those being Crazy Ollie sharing, was practicing Uno when she pulled these cards. Yes, it was a perfectly harmless game. Oh no, wait, it actually turned into a punishment game, where Vestia Zeta made the other three, such as Oyunda Risu, recite lines like this one.
Let me do it for you. Woof. Let me do it for you. Ow. Let me do it for you. Kermit.
Okay, all right. Lastly, Nijisanji English, we have Remo Indo. accurately shown off here in all of her fine profile. Thanks again to Unfamous Radish for that one-to-one artwork there, as this liver was also experiencing some issues with Twitter, stating, "I hate the new For You tab on Twitter Mobile. What are all these random people with random threads I don't wanna? Give me back Hatsune Miku on my timeline." No, Reimu, unfortunately, Twitter is currently very busy sending out tweets where they don't belong. But it turns out Reimu did belong here, playing some Apex Legends with Fruit and Zentrea of V-Shoujo. Afterwards saying, "I suck at Apex, but Apex is fun. It's fun again. Thank you, Zen and Fruit, for letting me warm up to the game again. You both are cracked." Unfortunately, Reimu was let down by Amazon, as her copy of Resident Evil 4 Remake did not arrive today, so instead she'll have a members-only chill talk stream. And tomorrow we'll be playing some Valorant alongside members of Nijisanji English and also Hollow Stars Japan member Astoleta. And now, speaking of Hololive Production Japan, we turn to our co-host Co-Dee, bringing us even more things VTubers say.
It's day 5 of Hololive. Not really, but we did get a 5th anniversary celebration this week from your shooting star, your diamond in the rough, idol VTuber Hoshimachi Suisei. Suisei's birthday and 5th anniversary featured 2 guest appearances, one from Kafu, the virtual singer signed to Kamitsubaki Studio, and has also been around from 2018. The other appearance being Leia, the lead singer from the all-girl band Razor Sealant, who sang a duet of Suisei's original song, Michizure. The known gacha whale Suisei went on to continue to pull SSRs by bringing on the entire RAS lineup to sing their original song, Hell or Hell, where Holofan Itori managed to capture the moment of some serious headbanging. Leia went on to tweet a photo of a signed copy of Spectre, saying, "I was able to perform on a memorable and important day for my beloved Suisei. Being able to sing together was an unforgettable experience." Post-concert, Suisei went on to reveal 5 announcements. First up, we got merch, which includes keychains designed by Reiruka. In pure gacha style, you will receive one at random when purchasing.
I can hear the talalas.
The other announcements include a Midnight Grand Orchestra Blu-ray release for their first live overture, as well as a second mini album in the works. We have an upcoming Suisei Curry collaboration starting on April 10th, and Suisei will also be in charge of singing a song for a TV ad on behalf of HAL Tokyo, a school in Shinjuku that trains professionals in games, animation, music, and IT. The last of the 5 announcements was an NHK FM radio broadcast appearance, along with Rika of Holostars Gen 1. Just as we thought the concert was over, Suisei pulled a Marvel-style after-credits scene by finally releasing a 2023 remastered version of Next Color Planet, but opening the song using her first model and upgrading through the designs until we got to the latest idol outfit, bringing everyone to tears, including Crony Virus. Sui squeezed one more tease in as she ended the live, giving fans something to expect on April the 1st. Additionally, a music video for Michizure premiered with a plethora of people working on the video, including Shime Saba, Chloa working on VFX, Delph, and many, many others. In other music news, we take a look at the Candy Princess, Himemori Luna, who collaborated with Yamaha Japan and all of the fans to create a Luna-themed electone. This is now complete, and although it cannot be purchased, it will be on exhibition at various Yamaha venues, starting with Tokyo Sky Tree Town on March 25th. Next up is Holonina, the collaborative project between Deco Nina and Hololive, which last week took first and second place of the Japanese Billboard charts for download albums, and also took the 4th and 6th spot for hot albums. Lastly, in music news, we turn to Hololive ID's Kobo, who has teased her second original song called Oh Romance, and will be released on her anniversary, the 27th of March. In other news, we turn to the elite idol Sakura Miko, who in a previous episode, we reported she had lost access to her main account, but as of March 23rd, has finally had it restored. Miko went on to tweet, "I've got it back. Thank you, everyone. I'm going to continue using my sub account for daily tweets and stuff." Keen Biscuit created some art of Miko busting out of jail, saying, "Welcome back." Meanwhile, Miko has been appointed an ambassador for Weiss Schwartz, alongside Suisei, Muna, and Kiara. Miko added, "They will all be active in events and PR activities in Japan and around the world." The Hololive Production Volume 2 booster packs will be released on March 24th. And on the topic of Muna Hoshinova, we've just received our first ever PekoMoon Off Collab. Muna tweeted, "Today I will make burger with Pecora." This as Peko has misread it, thinking she will be the burger. Pecora went on to tweet using her elite English skills, saying, "Once upon a time, PekoMuna collabo. First off collabo together. Eat Derish House burger, Muna burger, and Pecora burger. Foreign love. Let's her cook. No! Beef meat, okay? Let's make a cocking." Leaving Muna to reply with, "That's what she said." And the last Hololive member we check out today is Yozora Mel, who will be teaming up with Momosuzu Nene and Vark Official to deliver a Cinderella Switch performance on the 25th of March. And 2 days later, Violeta will be unveiling a brand new costume, with the vampire asking fans to take a guess at what it would look like. And before I hand it back to the studio, I will be participating in a charity stream on March 26th, where I will attempt to win some money for Angat Bohai, a Filipino foundation focusing on anti-poverty through health, education, food security, and disaster risk response. This will all go live on twitch.tv/yinisdead. But that's everything from me. Back over to you, False.
Thank you so much, Co-Dee. Also, a thank you to Shoga, the V artist, giving us this newsman eye banner. I'm entranced. All while we have Kirby Austria giving us this illustration of reading the stories. It's like looking into a mirror. And that is all for this episode. As always, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe below. Send your VTuber news into our Discord. We record live on twitch.tv, and we'll have more things VTubers say for you soon.